Hey everyone, my name is Kate and this is the second episode of Kotlin Multiplatform Multiverse. In this series of videos, I will show you how to develop cross-platform mobile applications with Kotlin Multiplatform Mobile. In the previous episode, we discussed what Kotlin Multiplatform Mobile is, how it works in general, and how to set up your environment. Today, we will create our first cross-platform mobile application using KMM in less than 10 minutes. Of course, this step will be pretty simple, but don't worry. In future episodes, we will cover a variety of more complex topics, from working with platform-specific APIs to publishing multi-platform libraries, as you ask in the comments. Over the course of the series, we will cover everything you'll need to implement all your exciting ideas. But today, we want to start from the beginning. In this video, I use the latest stable version of Kotlin, Android Studio beta version, and the latest version of the KMM plugin. If you're wondering what version to use, check the KMM plugins releases page. It lists the details of the latest KMM plugin releases, including compatibility information. I should also note that I'm using macOS, as I want to build both Android and iOS applications. Let's first discuss what a typical Kotlin multi-platform mobile project looks like. Basically, it contains two regular platform projects, one Android and one iOS. They use a common Kotlin multi-platform module that is built using the multi-platform Gradle plugin. The good news that we don't need to create these projects and configure all the connections manually. Instead, we can use the handy project wizard that comes with the KMM Android Studio plugin. So, what are we waiting for? Let's create our first project and play with it a bit. Click Create New Project and choose KMM Application. The first step isn't any different from creating any Android project. We need to provide a name and set a minimum SDK version. This will only really affect the Android part of our app. The next step is to configure the applications and shared module names, but I think I'm okay with the default ones. Let's also add sample tests for the shared module. Click Finish and let's see what we get. Let's start exploring our project. First of all, switch the project view from Android to Project so you can see all the contents of the root directory, including the iOS part. This wizard doesn't generate the project structure and configuration files only. It also generates sample code, which might be useful to learn from. Though the KMM learning curve may sometimes seem quite steep, having a sample ready-to-run project at hand could help you become familiar with it. I suggest we start with something familiar and see what we have in our platform projects. In the Android project, there is a single activity with a text view. The text comes from the grading class of our shared module. Let's run our application and see how it works. What about iOS? There is an amazing feature in the KMM plugin. We can run an iOS application directly from Android Studio without having to run Xcode. So I just need to select the predefined run configuration and click Run. The application looks pretty much the same as expected. I also want to see how the iOS application is implemented, so let's open Xcode for that. I used to use the terminal with a shell alias to do this, but the KMM plugin actually lets us open it right from the project tree. The generated project uses Swift UI, and like we can see in the Android app, there is a single view with the text that we get by calling the grading function of the grading class, which was written in Kotlin. Our applications looks quite simple, so let's go back to Android Studio and explore the most interesting parts, the shared Kotlin module and the connections it makes between different parts of the project. In the project we generated, we have a root Gradle project that holds the shared module and the Android application as subprojects. They are linked via the Gradle multi-project mechanism, and two modules are included in the settings Gradle file. The iOS Xcode project is stored in a separate directory within the root project. Xcode uses its own build system, and because of this, the iOS project isn't connected with other parts of the KMM project via Gradle. Instead, it uses the shared module as an external artifact, a framework, which was used in the SwiftUI content view we saw earlier. We'll look at the details of this integration a little bit later. Before we turn to that, let's check the shared module, which contains the core application logic. The best way to explore it is to check out the bild.gradle file, of course. This module uses Gradle with the Kotlin Multiplatform plugin and has targets for Android and iOS, so it compiles into an Android library and an iOS framework. The target is the part of the build that is responsible for building, testing, and packaging the application for a specific platform. While in our case we have Android and iOS targets declarations, you can easily add JS target, for example, provide some platform-specific implementations if needed, and add web front-end support to our application. But I suggest focusing on mobile development today. The shared module contains the code that is common for both the Android and the iOS applications. However, to implement the same logic on Android and iOS, you sometimes need to write two platform-specific versions of it, for example, to connect with Defy's file storage or to access the camera. To handle such cases, Kotlin offers the expect-actual mechanism. The source code of the shared module is organized in three source sets accordingly. Common main stores the code that works on both platforms, including the expect declarations. In our case, we have a declaration of an expect class called platform, because in order to get the information about the device operating system, we need to access platform-specific APIs. The actual implementation of such expect functions is stored in platform source sets, Android main and iOS main. Here we can see how platform libraries are used. Each source set has its own dependencies. And there are also three matching test source sets, common test, Android test, and iOS test. You can use them to store the unit tests for common and platform-specific source sets accordingly. Let's see what else we have here. The configuration of the Android library produced from the shared module is typical for Android projects. In addition to Kotlin Multiplatform, the Android library Gradle plugin is used. The configuration of the Android library is stored in the Android top-level block of the shared module's build script. In iOS applications, the shared module compiles into a framework file that is produced via the Kotlin native compiler. The framework configuration is stored in the iOS block of the build script. It defines the output type framework and the string identifier base name that is used to form the name of our output artifact. Really, complex projects may require much more complex configuration, of course, and you can learn more about the details of framework production configuration in the multiplatform documentation. Check out the links below this video. Additionally, there is a Gradle task that exposes the framework to the Xcode project from which the iOS application is built. It gets the configuration of the iOS project from environment variables and uses this information to define the build mode, debug release, and provide the appropriate framework version to the specified location. For each build of the iOS application, the project obtains the latest version of the framework. And to do this, it uses a run script build phase that executes the pack for Xcode Gradle task we just saw. I should quickly add that this is, of course, not the only way to connect your shared module to platform projects. Android integration is pretty straightforward. You can build a separate multi-platform project and upload the result Android artifact to a local or a remote Maven repo. For iOS, you can use the CocoaPods integration plugin, which encapsulates integration details and allows you to add a dependency on a shared module just as you would with any other regular library. If you want to store your platform projects and shared modules separately, you can provide a pre-built artifact and connect it using CocoaPods or even Swift Package Manager. But this approach requires some configuration, and we will dive into the details of this in one of our future episodes. So stay tuned! Okay, I think that's enough theoretical explanation. Let's make some changes in the shared module and see what the result is on both platforms. I want to make our grading a little more festive, so in addition to the device information, let's also show the number of days left until the new year. To do this, I'm going to use the Kotlinx datetime library. It has full multi-platform support, so I will only need to update the common code. Let's first add the dependency to the common main source set. In the grading class, I will create a short function that calculates the number of days from today until the new year, using the datetime's date arithmetic. And I will use the result of this function to update my grading string. And we're all done! Let's check out our apps. It looks like everything is working as expected. But if it isn't, you can always debug your application on both platforms. This ability to debug your application on iOS comes from the KMM plugin. Let's put a breakpoint here and make sure the next year is calculated properly. And, of course, it is. And last but not least, remember how we also created sample tests for our app. Let's use them to make sure we haven't broken the logic. We are testing platform-dependent logic. So there are two tests, one in the iOS test source set and one in the Android test source set. We can run a test separately using the gutter on the particular test class or test method. Or we can use the check-gradle task to run all the tests for all targets at once. And success! Okay, let's wrap everything up for now. Today, we've created our first KMM application using the project wizard in the KMM Android Studio plugin. We learned a lot about the KMM project structure, including how the shared module is configured and how it's connected to iOS and Android native projects. We modified our application a little by adding a dependency on the Kotlin Daytime Multiplatform Library. And we looked at how you can run, test, and debug your application on both platforms. Now you have a good starting point for exploring cross-platform mobile development with KMM. But of course, this is just the beginning of our exciting journey. In the next episode of Kotlin Multiplatform Multiverse, I will demonstrate how you can use the Kator HTTP client to make API requests and process the data, all in the shared module. So don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and I look forward to seeing you then. Thanks for watching, and take care!